At any given time, you have control of where this hoop will sit. Now, we're talking about hoop positions like park and a trim position and center. So we're talking about once you have a design on screen and you've already selected embroidery stitch out. So your embroidery arm has moved over. I'm going to go ahead and attach the embroidery hoop. Listen to that good click so you know it is firmly attached. And right now, in relationship to where the needle is and the screen, the needle is sitting right here where the plus is. So it's going to start at the lower part of that design. So wherever the first stitch is, that's where it's going to move the hoop to first. Now, for any reason you need to, and here let me show you what we're talking about, hoop position. So the first one is actually hoop position, which is where we are right now. We'll use that more at the end here. Next one, let's use actually the one I use the most. It's called a trim position. So a lot of times when I embroider, I will open up my hoop position menu and kind of stay here because I'll be using what's called a trim position. Now notice that the hoop comes towards you and I actually had to take a step back so it didn't hit me. If you're sitting at your embroidery machine, you also might make sure your chair is going to roll or move backwards. Come and catch you, you don't want it to touch or tap you at all. But look where the needle has moved. The needle has moved to the top right corner. Now, in the hoop projects that are stitching things with like zippers or applique, this allows you to actually do any trimming or work here in this open area while the hoop is attached to the machine. I'm going to tell you a secret. Not all brands have this feature, and they're always jealous of the FAF Creative Icons in our class because the FAF people can just go ahead, touch trim position, and then do their little cut, cut, cut. They don't have to take their hoop off. And then this first icon, if you want to touch it, it will bring you back to the stitch that you will be starting on next. Now, you don't have to actually touch that. If you just push the start button on your machine, your needle, just like it did, will move back to where it needs to go. But if you kind of want to just make sure everything's aligned up and the hoop doesn't catch it on the way back in, if there's a lot of layers, you definitely can touch that. Let's go ahead and touch this last one. This one is actually just kind of moving the hoop to a center position. Again, it could also help if you were doing something towards the bottom, just moves that needle to the center of the hoop. Now, I kind of skipped this one on purpose, but we'll do it now. The one with P for park. So what it's going to do, it says it needs to remove the hoop. What we're talking about is the embroidery arm that the hoop is attached to is going to move out of position. So when you touch OK, it's moving all the way at that point. Now that would be where your embroidery unit would fit best into your embroidery case. A lot of times too, when you switch over to the sewing mode, that embroidery unit arm moves off to the left as well. So really that's kind of its, well, park position. But if you need to ever do that, it does ask for the hoop to come off, no big deal. You can always come right back to current position and it'll pull it back in. So it's super easy to do all those hoop positions. I will tell you right now though, the one you'll use the most is the trim position. That's the hoop with the pair of scissors on it. So as I get to a project that I'll be showing you on video, you'll see me use that once again.